what makes head and neck cancer resections and Penn ENT better than most other institutions is that we are giving patients an opportunity that they wouldn't normally have.
Then we can extend either direction.
We have much greater understanding now at a molecular level into what makes one tumor different from another. We're just now starting to make progress in how to use that information to individualize treatment for every patient.
We have been using decreased radiation fields and sometimes eliminating chemotherapy by doing a very targeted type of surgery to the back of the throat using the surgical robot. In fact, the technique was invented at Penn.
Transoral robotic surgery is a minimally invasive surgical technique that allows us to go through the mouth with surgical robotic instruments and resect cancers and offer the patients a better approach for both cure and functional outcome in terms of swallowing and long-term results than the standard treatment.
The resection involves removing the right amount of abnormal tissue and the appropriate amount of normal tissue to get a good margin and make sure that patient is cancer-free.
It's a paradigm shift. It has changed the way we manage throat cancer.
Right now at Penn, we are really pioneering the use of imaging to help us see tumors better. One of the technologies called Tumor Glow, injecting patients with a fluorescent dye that seems to link to tumors, that's literally lighting up during the surgery, allowing us to do a better job of both removing all of the cancer, but also saving a lot more of the normal tissue and leaving that behind, which in the head and neck area is very critical.
Head and neck cancer is entering a new era. Though surgery is still a big part of how we treat it, we're now seeing other treatments like immunotherapy, better radiation therapy, less side effects. And so that allows us to treat the cancer and see our patients surviving longer and living better lives.
So this is tumor, and then I think this is tumor at the mandible, right?
We have a very diverse multidisciplinary tumor board where every cancer patient is presented.
We have a common ground when we come together, where we share ideas, where we question each other and challenge each other in terms of what we're proposing as a collective Penn multidisciplinary approach to tumors and to cancers.
There is no area of medicine that I find as multidisciplinary as the care of a person with oral cancer. So that's number one. Number two is making sure that that team has pathways in place that aim to address every aspect of the person's care.
We have the reconstructive surgeons, the surgeons who are removing the cancer. We have our swallowing therapists, we have our nutritionists, our social workers, and we really try to hone down on each individual patient's needs before, during, and after their treatment.
Six or seven physicians all talking about their experiences and then saying, hey, I think this is the best way to approach this cancer. And we do that with everybody. Before, we'd be doing these surgeries where it'd be disfiguring. Take out the tumor, great, but then patients can't swallow, they can't eat, they're stuck at home. That's not a life that a lot of people want to live. Now they don't have to.